Hi there, my name is Jason Caldwell, and I'm the lead developer for the S2 Member plugin for WordPress. And it is my pleasure to introduce S2 Member to you. In this video, this is just an introductory video. I'm going to talk a little bit about what S2 Member is, what it does, what it's capable of, and I'm also going to show you how to install it and how to get started with it as quickly as possible, which is actually pretty easy, especially if you already have content that you want to protect and sell access to. All right, so let's get started. I'm here at WordPress.org, and I've pulled S2 Member up from the Plugins tab here at the top. You can just search for S2 Member using the search box here, and that'll bring you to this page. And of course, you can learn all about S2 Member from this page. However, you can also go, I'm going to switch tabs here for a moment. You can also go to s2member.com/framework, or just go to s2member.com, and here at the top, choose the framework. This is the free version of our plugin that we were just looking at WordPress.org. And I'm actually on that page right now. You can use these tabs across the top to learn all about S2 Member and even follow along with our changelog to see how we're progressing as we move forward with S2 Member. Farther down the page here, you'll find a list of features. These are expandable, so you can open them up and take a look at a feature comparison between S2 Member and S2 Member Pro. If you have questions along the way, we would encourage you to use our search box here at the top. Or you can navigate through our support panel here in the support menu. You'll find that we have a codex for S2 Member, where all of the source code has been documented, along with over 1,000 hooks and filters that are available for developers to integrate S2 Member in more creative ways. There's a knowledge base for S2 Member, where we have our support reps who have written many, many articles about S2 Member to address common questions and problems and ways to work around those. You can also take a look at other video tutorials, our FAQs, and our support forums are available. If you'd like to join our community forums, you can use this link up here at the top left, where it'll bring you to our free registration form. And you can get into our forums and get help from other site owners, share ideas. So we would encourage you to do that. We also have S2 Member Pro available. You can learn more about S2 Member Pro in this area of our website, where we have support for on-site credit card processing through additional payment gateways like PayPal Pro, Authorize.net, ClickBank, Google Checkout are supported by S2 Member Pro as well. And with your purchase of S2 Member Pro, you also gain access to priority support through our customer support forums. So this provides several other features and additional functionalities. All right, let's take a look at how to install the free version of S2 Member, the S2 Member framework. All right, I'm just going to switch tabs here for a moment where I've already got a quick test site where I've put this together for the video, and this is the back end of that site, and it's powered by WordPress, obviously, and I'm here in the plugins menu, and I've chosen Add New, and I just type S2 Member into the search box, and let's search for S2 Member so that we can install it. And here it's the first item in the list. We're looking for the S2 Member framework, and right now we're at the time of this video, we're at version 12.02.13. Which actually indicates that this version of the plugin was released on February 13th of the year 2012. So that's how our version numbers work. They indicate the release date as well. So we just choose Install Now. And let's choose OK just to confirm that's what we want to do. Okay, so the download begins. WordPress will download the latest release of S2 Member from the plugins repository. It will unzip it and install it into the proper location. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Now, if you were to do this manually, perhaps through an application like FileZilla, where you were FTPing the application to your website, let's take a look. I'm going to open up another window here. Let's pretend for a moment that this is your installation of WordPress. You will always have a WP content folder, and then you will have a plugin subfolder. These are things common to all WordPress installs. Okay, and this is where you will place the S2 Member folder. So you would download the zip file, unzip it, and place the S2 Member directory here. And upon activating S2 Member, you will also get the S2 Member files and S2 Member logs directories. S2 Member creates these directories for you automatically. Okay, so just to be aware of that, these two directories should remain writable on your web server. This one will hold log files should you choose to enable logging in the future. And this is designed to hold protected file downloads if you decide to use that aspect of S2 Member. Okay? One thing to be aware of if you do a manual installation is to be sure you don't accidentally nest two S2 Member folders together. If we open the S2 Member folder, we should have immediately inside the s2member.php file. That's the core plugin file. Okay, what we want to avoid is if you have WP content, plugins, S2 member, then another S2 member directory, and then these files, then you've done something wrong. Okay, you should have WP content, plugins, S2 member, and then these files and subdirectories where you have s2member.php. This is correct. Okay, but let's go back to the dashboard. Because 99% of the time, this is how S2 member is installed, because this is really the simplest way. And here, everything happens automatically. Now, after the plugin has been installed, we just choose Activate. Okay, so that's it. S2 member is now installed. It says actually been reactivated, because at one point I had it installed on this site. So it just says reactivated, but you'll have a similar message. And it says, have fun, make some money. So that's it. S2 member is now installed. All right, so now the question becomes, okay, what is S2 member going to do for me? What is it capable of? What am I going to be able to accomplish with S2 member? So I'm going to get into a little bit of that and the initial configuration of S2 member in the very next segment of this video.